Okay, it's 10:37, 10:38 right now. See, that's the President Trump banner I have on the front porch. I sit here in this chair looking out, and I see that wind blowing out there like that. And I'm going to zoom across here real quick. I don't know if you can see. Shoot, I ain't going to work like that. No, that's north. That's the northern direction out there. And the thunder just started coming up, and I was going to start recording so you'd hear the thunder too. But it was sprinkling a little rain. Wind really picked up a lot more like it usually does. But and then it started thundering really bad, and I thought, well, I'll record that while I'm in the house here and you can hear it. Again, we got about at least, I'd say, 3/4 of a mile to our north before there's one house trailer in a corner like bend of the road. To the south of us is about half a mile. There's a curve that goes by a cemetery. East and west, at least 1 mile before it hits a road. So we're out in the middle of nothing out here. And you've seen the shed that was blown from around the corner, around back of the house. It was fastened to a 10x10 platform. And the F1 tornado actually took it up off the platform, went north with it about maybe, I would say, at least 15 feet to get it around the corner from the house, and 35 feet east until it crashed into a tree. So the winds out here are nasty. We have a storm like this coming up. Oh, I put my solar panel up on the back porch because even though I had cement thing out there to hold it down from the winds out here. Where's that cement thing at? Shoot, right there. You can barely see it through the blinds. That cement thing right there. That would hold it down, but we're supposed to have some hail, which again denotes maybe a tornado coming. You know, I go out the back door, which is south. I mean, west, rather. Okay, going west. When I open the back door, we'll face directly west. Listen to some of my early deterrents. Hear that, don't you? There's a reason for that. I don't want that squeak to stop. Yeah, see, that's the shed. The platform the shed was on right there. It was bolted down, screwed down, with about 4, 8, 12, at least 16 screws onto it. And the F1 tornado took it. You see, it came all the way right back here. Right there. So it overhung about 3 feet. Only 3 foot of it overhung. It raised it up, took it north about 15 feet around, and threw it 35 feet into the tree, which you see on an earlier video. A bird on the... hook for CJ and Lucy. That's kind of nice. I just flew off over there on the chair. I recovered that fireplace. I mean, I need about 9 more stones to complete 4 high, and it's nice and solid. I'm not going to cement it. I just have them stacked, so. But yeah, see, right now it's just, the storm is coming. Again, DirecTV and Dish Network, their marketing plan says 85 miles in that direction is Memphis. That's our local here. That's the marketing department. You know, a bunch of idiots that don't know shit. Jackson is about 12 miles the opposite, southwest, southeast of us. 85 miles north, I mean south. Yeah, I didn't get my mind straight. Jackson is about 12 miles southeast of us, but the marketing says 85 miles southwest is our local. I grew up in a big city. If you go more than 20 miles from your location, your weather is night and day, folks. But you know, the marketing people go, oh, so there you go. And I bitch about that every time I get the chance because it's wrong, and it just proves that they don't care. So much for Dish Network and DirecTV, huh? You can get your own locals. Yeah, you can get ABC, CBS, and NBC. Those are networks. You're not getting your locals. So, depending on the marketing, of course. Because if marketing says it is, you'll get it. Yeah, this is just aggravating. I can't do it. It's been saturated here since December 31st. We've had rains in the end of December, and it's the 9th of March now. And look at the, I mean, this is, it's really disgusting, making me aggravated. But I got all this stuff. We have to have a friend come over with his pickup truck and haul a lot of this. 99% of this is going to go to a dump. I might break up some of this wood and put it over by the fire pit over there to have just for extra burning. We're going to put our squash and broccoli and some things right here in this 10x10 area now. Oh, goodness. Can't do anything, though. Not as long as it's soggy out here. It goes a day or two without raining, then we have more rain, and then while we're having storms today, so. Like I said, see, that's what I'm talking about. Just under a half mile that direction. I mean, just over a half mile over that direction is that trailer. It's a mile back that way to one road, and the opposite, when you go east, the same thing. And down there is a cemetery. It's got World War II soldiers in there. This camera doesn't shut off. It is a Sony. But the curve right down there, that's about half a mile down that way. So we're right in the middle, half a mile each way, and then a mile east and west. And the winds come out here really nasty. You know, like I said, if this doesn't say anything about how bad the winds have been out here, then, well, it did damage the downspout a little bit, as you can see that bent end there. Other than that, it didn't do anything to the house. Oh, boy. Look at all this stuff, man. This is disgusting. To have it so neat and have it really organized inside the shed so it didn't look like this, and now this is how it looks. God, man. That shows you what happens out in the open. Yeah, see, it seems like it's not so bad, but the storms are still coming. You know, this is like the forefront before the storm starts. You hear thunder once in a while. See the clouds moving. Yeah, so. Gosh. Well, there's some water we can filter. About 3,000 gallons. I want to flush it out and put more well water, even though it's got glyphosate in it from the farmland around us. Think about that too, 360 acres of Monsanto toxic food-like products being developed on the land all the way around us. Okay, so it gets into the water, but I have a E. coli water filter. I don't even know the name anymore. Jeez, I'm so tongue-tied. But it 100% filters out the glyphosate. Most of the others don't filter out 100%. They'll filter out some. None of the pitcher-type ones do more than about 10 or 12, 20 to 30% tops. Some of the other water filters may get about 60 to 70%. But an E. coli Blue is what it is. Water filter. Big Berkey. I'm sorry. E. coli Blue. I'm sorry. Big Berkey. God, I feel so bad now. The Big Berkey water filter is what we use. They filter out 100% of glyphosate. I saw that car going by, but I don't... Oh, there he goes. Okay. Yeah, the Big Berkey water filter is what we use. It does about 2 gallons on the top, 2.5 gallons on the top, and down to a 2-gallon, like a water cooler type thing on the bottom where you have a spigot to get water. Fill up gallons of water, put them in the refrigerator. We have three at all times in the refrigerator. We got about 75 of them in the house, plus two 15-gallon buckets, plus this 3,000-gallon water right here. And it'll filter it, and you can drink it. And if you're really paranoid, boil it if you have to, but it'll be filtered. So, this is almost 10 minutes now, so 9 minutes and 16 seconds. Yeah, I mean, look at all the remnants out here, all the branches that have been knocked down. Okay, folks. See, here's my panel. Got it covered with this heavy plywood wedged in there. So if any hail came, it won't bust it.